Today, we're finally answering all those full-time RV questions that you guys have been asking us forever.
Even the personal questions. And yes, I wear briefs.
Before we dive into all of our questions, I just want to let you know that we aren't going to be able to answer every single question that we've gotten, but we did take the most popular questions, compiled them, and we're going to answer those here today and put it on our frequently asked questions page that's going to be brand new on our website.
Yeah, Stacy spent all day today putting the FAQs together. And when I say all day, she didn't shower till like 2:30.
Hey, shh.
Yeah.
Tell them my secrets.
Just saying.
All right, so let's dive right in. First question is, what channels would we recommend?
Ours.
All right, so when it comes to YouTube channels, you guys all know about all the popular ones. Everybody talks about them, so we don't need to talk about those. What we want to share today are the little channels that you may not have heard of yet.
That's right, and the usual suspects have probably been on our channel or mentioned a time or two before, so we're going to concentrate on the following channels.
All right, so the first one up is one of our favorite people, A Year to Volunteer.
Well, there's actually two people in that Year to Volunteer, Phil and Char, and they have the same initials as us, so what's not to love about them? And they're retired Navy, so they're doing great things. They are on a mission to volunteer throughout the U.S.
You can volunteer to go with them just like we did. We've done two projects so far and we loved every minute of it. It was really great to be able to give back. So if you're looking for an opportunity to give back, make sure you check them out. You can also always find a list of upcoming projects for them on our website under the volunteer tab. Our next channel we've actually mentioned a couple times this week. So if you haven't been over there yet, this is your third warning to hop over and check out RV East Coast.
Yeah, his editing just pulls you in and you want to sit there and you want to watch the story of Eli and Fawn as they're out. They're part-timers, but man, let me tell you, they're onto something.
Yeah, I totally agree. All right, next up, he's actually been on our channel before. The last time was for the Tampa RV show, and that was the Hungry Cuban.
AKA Chef Juan, as we call him. They've been full-time for about 3 years, I think. So if you haven't heard of the Hungry Cuban, check them out.
Next up is Endless RVing.
Yeah, Izzy and MJ, they had us on their channel a few months back. It was actually the first time that we virtually met them. And they were really fun to hang out with for an hour. They're part-time RVers, but they're doing great things out there. They've got a young and up-and-coming channel, so give them a look.
Yep, finally, a very humorous channel. When we met them, we did not stop laughing. And they are, or their channel is Does Size Matter?
Go check them out. You'll see what we're talking about. They are friends from up north, so we know they're probably stuck in Canada waiting to get down here.
They do a lot of RV tours, so if you're still looking for that perfect RV, go check them out. They have a lot of tours on their website for you to peruse through. Finally, our last one we are going to shove at you today are our awesome friends from Adventurous Way.
Yeah, Matt and Diana, if you haven't found them, go over and check out their channel. They're on a mission to visit every national park unit that we have here in the U.S. And they're not your traditional Texans. Just go check out their channel and you'll find out right away.
They have some clever, clever things on their blog as well as their channel. So make sure you give them some love. Next question is, knowing what you know now, would you still make the move to full-time RVing?
Without a doubt, yes.
Yeah, that's probably the easiest question we got from you guys.
Yeah.
And without a doubt, we would do it. As a matter of fact, I do regret that we didn't do it years and years ago. So if I had to do it all over again, we would have bought a small trailer, something, and we would have shoved our kids in it every week, got them out of the house, and forced it on them as kids.
Yeah, we had forced family fun, but we would have really forced some family fun by taking them out into the wilderness and unplugging. That would have been awesome to do.
Now, have you ever met someone who regretted going full-time and quit?
We've never met anybody, no.
I've only heard stories, and usually it's people who were not financially prepared, or they had a ton of issues with their RV as far as repairs and breakdowns and all that, and it just got overwhelming, so they threw in the towel.
If there's one piece of advice we can give anybody, it's to have an exit plan and emergency fund before you set out. That way, when things happen, you're prepared.
Yep. And always know things will go wrong in the RV all the time. So just expect things to break, know they're going to break, and don't be upset when they do, because it will and does happen. So we're going to dive into some of the personal questions. Now, we do have a long video that goes over a lot of these questions, so we're only doing the cliff notes here, and I will link the video below. All right, first up, Phil, what did you do in the Navy?
I had a lot of fun. No, I was 27 years in the world's greatest Navy. I started out as an enlisted cat, rose through the ranks, was an E-8, put in for a commission, retired as a lieutenant commander as a security officer.
All right. And for me, I was also in the Navy for 5 years. I was a data processor back when that actually existed.
30 years ago.
And that's how we met. We actually met both stationed in Yokosuka, Japan at the same time.
Yeah. So I say security officer, it's military law enforcement is what I did, military police.
Yep. All right. Where are the kids? Do you have kids?
Yeah, we have two. I don't know where they are. They're somewhere.
So Brianna is married actually to an active duty Navy guy. They are up in Illinois and he is pushing boots right now. And our son Andrew is also active duty Navy and he is stationed in Virginia.
Yeah. And luckily for us, by the end of the year, they'll both be in the same spot. So we'll have one-stop shopping.
Yeah, that's going to be really cool.
Yeah.
Holidays, woohoo! Do you miss family and friends?
No. And yes. And let me explain. Being in the military, we never had our immediate family close by. So mm-hmm. we never had the luxury of dropping the kids off at grandma's house because grandma was too far away. When you move every couple of years, you do it anyway. So to us, it's the norm. We're used to yeah. doing that kind of thing.
And luckily for us, we've actually been able to see some of our old Navy family, which, you know, our great friends and our actual family members way more since we hit the road than ever before.
Right. And that's something we didn't even bank on
yeah.
when we started.
So next up is all about Gizmo, our sweet little Gizmo. Yep. What kind of pup is he?
Fat.
Yeah, he is actually pretty fat right now. He's an old man, too.
He is. Gizmo is a soon-to-be 13-year-old Shih Tzu American Eskimo mix, otherwise known as a Shitmo.
And do you leave him alone?
We do.
Most definitely. We actually treat our RV as our house. So just like when you got up and went to work every day and left your pets behind, it's kind of the same thing. But we do have to take some extra precautions.
Yeah, so we have a Govee Wi-Fi thermometer and humidity tracker. We can monitor Gizmo. We can get alerts 30 minutes or every 10 minutes, whatever our preference is. And we have preset parameters for the temperature. If it gets above our preset temps, then we know that we've either lost power, the AC stopped working, the auto gen didn't come on yeah. if we were boondocking, because we still do the same thing boondocking, it doesn't change anything. Or we drop power from the pedestal. Then we'll know, okay, the temperature is getting outside the parameters, we need to go back and check on him. And so far, our Govee thermometer has not let us down.
Yeah, we love it.
Yeah.
It really gives us that sense of peace and security so we know he's okay when we leave.
Right.
All right, what are those rings?
Bada boom.
So these are actually silicone bands. Yeah. We actually started wearing them years ago when we were kind of gym rats. We started wearing them so we wouldn't bend our rings and so we would stop getting pinched and calluses on our hands.
Right.
And then it just kind of evolved. They're fun. They're colorful. Yeah. I don't worry about ruining my settings when I'm off doing something, swimming, hiking, whatever.
Right.
Or losing my real wedding bands. So for us, it's just fun now.
Yeah, and we have had our real bands come off, mostly in the water. They've
yeah.
kind of slipped off. So these, like Stacy said, if we lose one of these, we don't care. You know, a few bucks.
How has RVing affected your relationship? Ooh.
It's brought us closer.
Oh. No, I'm just kidding.
No, actually, our RVing has allowed us to get back some of the time that was lost over the 27 years
yeah.
that I was gone. There was a lot of time apart, so we're getting some of that time back. And it has not been all that bad.
Oh, what do you mean all that bad?
Well, all the issues have been me, because sometimes I'm a knucklehead. So.
I know you're shocked by that,
yeah.
but...
So
let's just lead right into the next question.
Yeah.
Do you ever get sick of each other?
I never get sick of
you. Absolutely.
No.
And what do you do when you're sick of each other? How do you get a break? What's your break?
I just ignore you.
Well, you do that anyway.
Yeah. No, you ignore me.
So I go outside. Yeah.
I'll go outside. I'll either go for a bike ride. I'll go sit outside and in the shade and
yeah.
watch TV outside. Or I'll jump in a car and I'll go run an errand or something.
Sometimes it's just as simple as me putting on some headphones, listening, you know, watching my own movie or listening to a book, an audio book. And really, that's all I need just to kind of do my thing for a little bit.
Yeah.
And then he watches sports or whatever. And that's it. We're good to go.
Yeah. No, I mean, it's that simple.
Do you ever get lonely on the road? With this guy? No.
No. No.
Actually, we haven't had a problem with that. We started out within the first 3 months meeting people on the road and actually bonding and making really good friends. So we've been really lucky. We've never felt alone and we've never felt disconnected from people.
No.
Don't think it's just because we have a YouTube channel that we have these connections. Most of these connections started before we even had 500 subscribers. So they didn't even know we had a YouTube channel when we met them.
No.
Don't think that there's not an opportunity for you to have that same connection. A great place to find that would be on our village. Everybody there is either currently RVing, wants to RV, part-time RV, full-time RVs. So reach out, start talking to people, make connections, do the virtual hangouts until we can go back to real hangouts. So reach out and put yourself out there to make those connections.
Yeah, our village is great for meeting fellow like-minded RVers. That's how we met our first friends, was through our village. And it's just a matter of when you get to a park, check in. You'll be amazed at how many people you find that are from our village that are in the group and have checked into the same park.
Let's talk all about the sticks and bricks. Do you have a home base?
Well, we have a home port. So we do not own our home. We sold it when we went full time. Mm-hmm. So the only thing that we have is a 10x10 storage unit. But our home port is San Antonio.
Yes.
This is where we come back for medical appointments, the hair lady, most importantly. So we do come back here every 6 to 7 months.
How scared were we when we took the leap and sold our house and went full time?
Scared to death.
I wasn't scared at all. I was the one throwing everything out the door. Sell it. Get rid of it. And Phil was like, no.
No, Stacy was really the one pushing, saying, we can do this. Let's do it. When I say scared to death, it was the fear of the unknown. I had never driven anything that big behind us. So that had me more terrified than anything. But actually selling the house, we've sold houses before and moved. So I treated it kind of like that. Yeah. Although I did have a harder time getting rid of things more than Stacy did. Stacy was chucking it.
We never wish we had a sticks and bricks. We never miss it. Our home, our RV is our home now. So it feels, we have the same feeling when we walked in that we did when we walked into our house. So we don't miss it at all. Someday, I'm sure we will purchase another sticks and bricks, whether it's a house like we had before, a condo, I don't know what we'll end up with or where it will be. But eventually, whenever we decide to slow down, we will do that.
How did you choose a domicile, Stace?
Well, we were already residents of Texas, so it was easy for us. We joined Escapees, and all we had to do is head over to Livingston. We registered to vote there, changed the address on our driver's license, and we were pretty much set.
Yeah, I mean, it was that easy. The rig was already registered in Texas. It had Texas plates, so that was easy peasy.
Done. Now, we also get our mail from Escapees, and, you know, most of the time it's easy, and normally we get it about every month or so.
Yeah, it just depends on where we are and if we can receive mail where we're at.
All right, memberships. We only have a few memberships. We started out with a whole bunch, and we have dropped some off. So our current memberships are Harvest Host, Boondockers Welcome, Escapees, and FMCA. All right, you ready to talk Tiffin?
Yeah, let's talk Tiffin.
All right, we're going to talk about Ruby, which is the name of our RV. It's Ruby Red. If you had it to do all over again, would you buy a Tiffin?
Absolutely.
Yes, me too.
Yeah, Tiffin, they won us over just on their customer service stories from friends that actually had Tiffin. And then since we've owned a Tiffin, we've experienced those same customer service great stories that we heard about. So hands down, I would stick with Tiffin.
All right, Phil,
what do
you mean when you say doing your homework?
Gathering as much information as I can on whatever it is we're researching. If it was, you know, researching RVs, I did my homework. I researched every brand, every manufacturer, travel trailer, fifth wheel, class A, C, gas, diesel. I did it all. I wanted to be as informed as I could be when it came time to say, okay, this is what we're doing.
Yeah, so we knew what their warranties were, if they did their own repairs, if they sent you out, if they did their own repairs, what the reviews were for those repairs. So we went through all of that. And our first thing we did before we looked at floor plans is choose a manufacturer. So we kind of did it that way. And then we picked a floor plan within those manufacturers.
Right.
Next up is RV insurance.
Gotta have it.
That's right. Go ahead.
Well, and so when somebody asks, what's the best RV insurance? That's a loaded question because it depends on your rig, the year of your rig, whether it's a travel trailer, whether it's a motorhome, whether you're full-time, whether you're part-time, yeah. where you live comes into play.
Yeah, so, your zip code.
So when you, when I see people asking those questions, you may find somebody that's paying $1,200 a year, but they may have a 10-foot teardrop and they're part-timers.
Mm-hmm.
So that factors in. The first year that we had our insurance, we paid $1,700 because we were part-timers. The rig sat for a lot of that time. When we eventually went full-time, we changed our full-time to full-time coverage, the price went up to like $19,000. Now we're $1,900, sorry, good
Woo!
Catch. So now we're paying about $2,100 for full-time coverage. So do your homework again.
And make sure if you're full-time, your plan says full-time because that can get you into trouble later. And then you also want to know if your policy will cover you for full reimbursement of what you bought it for, or is it going to cover the Blue Book value? And there is a difference. If you want full reimbursement, then you're going to pay more than if you just got Blue Book. So there are a lot of things to look at when you talk about insurance. All right, if you had the bucks and money was no object, what RV would you buy? Make, size, layout, color, Phil, this is you because he's the dreamer.
You first. I want to hear what you have to say.
Oh, would you?
Yeah.
You want to guess for me?
Yeah, it'd be a Class C. Probably the Airstream Class C.
Yes.
Yeah. No, too small. I would probably go with a Integra. I just love the look. The outside look of the Integra to me is top notch. My number two would be an Allegro bus. They look different on the outside, but I just, those two models are the two that I would have to, I'd probably have to flip a coin.
And now you see why we have Ruby, because she is definitely the middle ground of those two.
Yeah.
I do not want to go any bigger than 35 feet because I don't want it to start eliminating us from some of the state and national parks. And Phil would not go an inch less than 35 feet. So that is definitely a good compromise for us. Are you always fixing things on the RV? And the answer is
no.
Well,
I wouldn't say fixing. I do preventive maintenance.
I was going to say maybe working on it.
Yeah, I do. I mean, when you're RV, you're constantly moving and there's constant torques and tweaks and bending, this, that, and the other. So you have to stay on top of it. Preventive maintenance, that's what I'm doing. So it doesn't take that long, but a little bit up front goes a long way in not having a major repair later.
That is true, but we've had some things break.
We have.
So it's not like things haven't broken. And sometimes it's just little teeny things that are more annoyances than problems. But I mean, we do have things that break. The blinds have broken. The roller or the motor's broken on both the shades. The stripping has broken on the slide twice. I mean, little things have broken, but none of it has been a big deal. But it is stuff you have to take care of.
Yeah, and you know, again, this thing is rolling down the road and it's moving in places that it shouldn't be moving. So
before we go any farther, we want you to check out our cool t-shirts.
Want to hook up?
Mine is getting toasted. It's kind of hard to see with, of course, s'mores down here. We want to send a special shout out to Ainsley from Life Unhitched for the t-shirts. They are super soft and we love them.
Yeah, this is a great fit. It's very comfortable. She's got a lot of quirky camping, funny sayings or slogans, so it's pretty cool.
I'll check it out. I'll put the link down below if you guys are interested and you can go check it out. The next question is, why do you need a gas stop if you have a regulator? Wait, before you answer the question, quickly and briefly, tell all of our newbies what the gas stop is.
The gas stop will shut off your propane in the event of a catastrophic leak or failure.
So it's an excellent safety device.
That's right, and they make them for our onboard propane tanks in the Class A, and they make them for the fifth wheel and travel trailer tanks as well.
Right. And so why do you need the gas stop if you also have a regulator?
Well, the regulator is just that. It regulates the pressure coming out of your tank from a very high pressure, goes through the regulator, comes out a low pressure into your RV, so it's not blowing out your hoses and shooting propane into your RV. Uncontrolled.
Right. And that being said, if that regulator breaks off, you have a hose going from your tank to the regulator. The gas stop fits right onto your tank. So in the event of any kind of issue or you have a catastrophic leak, it stops it at the tank.
That's right.
All right. Next up, let's talk about you, me, and the RV's videos. I get a lot of questions all the time about video creation. So first, what's the lag time between a video and the time you guys will see it? Well, that can be one day. Let's see, what's today? Yeah. It could be one day, or it can be, I think the longest we've gone is 8 weeks.
Right.
Do we find it difficult to enjoy a location and film at the same time?
No, not really. We know when we go out that we're going to film with a purpose. So we get the shots or the footage that we need, then we can put the camera down and we can still enjoy wherever we're at.
And that's true. And a bonus of having the camera is sometimes when I'm looking for things to show you guys, I notice things I probably would otherwise ignore. So it really helps me to pay attention to those little details of whatever location we're at.
Right. We were taught early on not to live this journey through the lens of the camera. And that's exactly what we don't do. We do put it down a lot.
Yeah. And there are many days I don't even take the camera out. We'll have a no filming day just so we can relax and enjoy it and not worry about thinking what we're filming, if we're filming enough or not enough. So we do that a lot. For my computer, I have a Mac. It is a 15-inch MacBook Pro. I use Final Cut Pro to edit. I actually started with iMovie a long time ago, just barely dabbling in a couple things for the kids and friends. And then after I got that down, I moved to Final Cut Pro. Next question is, what tips or advice would you have for anybody thinking of starting a YouTube channel? So my biggest tip would be, don't go out and buy any fancy equipment until you find out it's something that you really like doing. You don't mind putting in the time and hours, and you have a good time, and the person you're with is okay with it too, because you might do it for 6 months and decide it's too time consuming, you retired, you want to have fun, right, or whatever, and you don't want to spend a lot of money on equipment that you may not use in the long run.
Right. We used my iPhone 10 for the first year or so. Mm-hmm. We had a handheld gimbal that we used, and you guys don't even know the difference.
Next questions are about camp host. How did we get our foot in the door with our two camp host jobs?
We knew somebody. That's pretty much what it was. We had some friends that asked us if we wouldn't mind filling in for them the first time, and then the second time they had an opening or a few openings, and they said, hey, you guys want to try it again? So we did.
Yeah, we did. And it was cool. I don't know if we'll do it again. I'll never say never, but I'm not sure that I want to sit for that long a time.
Right.
Although we've sat here forever, we probably could have done a great job in the office while we've been sitting here. And advice for anyone thinking of becoming a camp host, apply early.
Yep.
I have a blog with all kind of tips on it. Of course, I'll link that below. Check that out, and that'll give you a lot of help along the way. Campgrounds, what amenity would you make mandatory at every campground?
Not so much an amenity, but a level site would be a beautiful thing.
Yeah, that's not a lot to ask for.
Nope.
We don't have to have full hookups, but a level site would be amazing. Let's talk about RVing neighbors. What do we think about neighbors?
We like them. I mean, we're normally not in a park long enough to meet all of our neighbors, because we're either out and about exploring or we're inside editing footage.
Yeah, so we don't meet many of our neighbors, especially when we're only somewhere for 3 days. And there have been times where we were just exhausted from exploring on previous locations where we were somewhere for 3 days and we didn't come out of the RV at all. And
no.
I'm sure our neighbors thought, what is wrong with them? They're all outside barbecuing, having a great time with family. We didn't get out of our jammies, so we haven't really had any bad neighbors.
No.
Maybe a barking dog here and there, but really nothing major.
No.
How do you watch TV, movies?
Most of the time it's over-the-air antenna that we get. We do have the Dish pay-as-you-go service as another outlet. We do stream Netflix, Amazon.
We stole our kids' Disney bundle.
Yeah, we swapped with the kids. They have our Netflix account and Amazon, and we have their Disney bundle. I watch more TV than Stacy does because she's got her headphones on and she's in front of her computer.
Next questions are, what is our favorite thing we've done and our favorite location?
Ooh, favorite thing we've done.
I got that one.
Okay, go ahead.
My favorite thing we've done is when we were in Cooperstown, we rented a pontoon boat with Life Beyond the Burbs, and the four of us had an amazing, relaxing day with no phones. We weren't connected because we're out in the middle of the lake. We jumped off, went swimming. It was just the most peaceful, relaxing day.
Yeah, that was a really good day. I can't wait to do that again.
The views were beautiful too.
Yeah.
So
I would say going up on top of Mount Washington, was it? On the Cog Railway?
Yeah, that was fun.
That was awesome. Just to ride that old rickety cog up there and then get to the top. I think that was probably one of the best things we've done.
Yeah, and both of those locations we were harvest hosting, so that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Mount Monadnock in New Hampshire was great on the way up. On the way down, not so much.
Yeah. Stacy, she does bounce when she falls because she caught her.
We proved that.
Yeah, she caught her ankle.
I was bigger then. I had a little more fluff, so I could bounce pretty good.
She caught her foot in between two rocks, and she was behind me, and she fell with a thud and with authority.
Yeah, that was a doozy.
We were probably still a mile and a half up the mountain, and she had to gut it. You too! She had to gut it down on that bum ankle. And when we finally did get down, her ankle was, I mean, it was nasty.
It took about 9 months for me to recover from that one. All right, guys, I'm interrupting this video, this Q&A video, because frankly, it's so long, I have to cut it in half. So Phil is out here working in the heat to get the rig ready for, guess what?
Getting bugs on the windshield.
That's right. We are getting ready to hit the road maybe next week, so you'll have to tune in. But in the meantime, we are going to end this video right here, so make sure you come back next Saturday to get the rest of our questions. And before you go, though, make sure you hit that subscribe button.
Give us a thumbs up and hit the notification bell.
And we will definitely see you on the road.